Hi, my name is Kwaku Rogers, and welcome to another Intro to R video focusing on creating headers, setting up packages, and working directories. We have our RStudio open, and I'm using the R scripts that I had in the last video. The first thing we need to do is to save our script to find it later. And knowing my spec lab organization for collaboration principles, I'm going to choose a file name that describes what this file does, the initials, and the date. I've already done this already, so I'll go ahead and jump into creating the header. Now, for the header, I want to describe who wrote it, the purpose for the script, and also the date that it was created and or last modified. Also include any additional information or descriptions that is relevant for a viewer or audience of the script to know. Now, from the last video, I used the hashtag, aka the pound sign, to indicate a line in my script that R should not run. A reminder is that these lines are known as comments. And using the header, I have created a comment essentially describing what my script is about. Additionally, I can use the hashtag to make my header look even more pretty. The next thing I want to do is to clear out my local environment. Now, this won't make a ton of sense to you now, but if I just switch over from this script while I was working on another project, there may be data objects and other things hanging around R's memory that linger in your local environment. On line 16, the command we use to fix this and erase all the previous data laying around is the rmlist=ls function. This command will do nothing if the environment is empty, in my case. Next, I'm going to install and load in any packages that I'm going to be using today. So, packages are batches of extra R commands and even datasets that aren't already included in the base R package that you've already downloaded. So we have to install these extra functions in R as we get started into our script. In the spec lab, we primarily use the tidyverse for data management, which includes the dplyr and the tidyr packages. And we use the ggplot2 for data visualization. So I will install and load both of these packages along with the readr package for our next video. The install.packages function is used to install the package, but make sure that when you are referencing the name of the package that you are installing, you surround it by quotation marks. Since I've already installed the package, I don't need to do this again, as you only need to do this once on your computer. So moving on, after you've installed your packages, you use the library function to load in the packages. On lines 24 through 26, you reference the name of the package that you are installing, but note that you will need to rerun the library function every time you open R to load in packages you've already installed. So now that I've installed and loaded in our packages and created my header, we're ready to load in data? Not quite. Before we can load in the data to get it to work, we need to set our working directory. Basically, we want to tell R where we're going to load things from and where we're going to save them to. On line 29, I use the setwd command to set the file path where I will be doing my work for this project. The working directory is simply the location that contains the data that I want to work with and where I may save any future outputs from R. In my case, I'm setting this working directory to the training data August 2021 folder, and you can access the latest training data from the spec website, uscspec.org/training data. I go ahead and set my working directory so that R needs to know to go to this folder every time I ask it to load something in or save something out. And after I ran this command, the console displays the directory path as proof that it has connected. The key thing here to note is that all information that is specific for me and my machine is here in my working directory. If I share this with my collaborator and they need to run it on their machine, they just comment out my setwd command with a new setwd command with their own file path. And now every command that follows, which entails loading in data, saving out pretty pictures, etc., it'll work just fine. A pro tip to keep in mind is that this will become relevant when you're working with multiple people with the same folders, as we do in the spec lab. There may be cases where your file path looks like / users, / your name, / share drive, / share folder name, etc., etc. But you can replace everything before / share drive with the tilde symbol so that anyone with the same folder on their folder or computer can run the same file path. If you always set your R script like this, you'll always be set up for a transparent, reproducible, totally awesome collaborative social science. We have two more intro to R videos to get you situated with how R thinks about data. And then you can go through our walkthrough documents and move on to our first data management module. In our next video, we will go into loading in and saving data sets.